Ben Woodruff here with another falconry video. I'm here today with my dear falcon, Amandra, and we're going to be talking about what to do if your bird keeps landing when you don't want them to. Now, one of the miracles of falconry is the fact that we are training species that are not mammals, and they don't speak a language anywhere close to us, and so to build trust and build understanding is great. But that is a balancing act back and forth the entire training process, and even when a bird is fully trained. So as you're well aware, if you're a falconer, or if you are watching some of my other videos, when we're building a relationship of trust with a bird of prey, we do it with food. Because in the wild, anybody's going to kill you and take your food except for your mate or your parent. So then you build that similar type of trust. You get them to eat off the fist, then hop to the fist, then fly to the fist. And then you switch to a lure, switch to hunting. But that's always a retrieval method, is having them fly to you for food or to the lure. Now, falcons and hawks are a little bit different, and you might be hunting in open country with your hawk, or you might be hunting a forest. But I want to address hawks first and why this is a potential problem. A hawk that learns, hey, this falconer set me on a perch, walked 50 feet away, called me to his glove. Okay, so all I have to do to get that human to do this behavior again is go land on a perch and he'll call me. So your hawk starts training you in this way. You're walking along looking for quarry. Your hawk takes off and you think, oh, they're chasing a rabbit. And then they land in a tree. They land on a telephone pole. They land on a fence post. And you're like, oh, well, I guess I'll call them back. Don't. There's nothing wrong with that, especially in an emergency. But the problem is your bird will start to refuse slips of wild game and instead choose to go land somewhere, because that is a far easier way for them to get an instant meal. I went and land, he calls me back, and I get my food. As opposed to, I'm gonna chase a rabbit, grab it, and wrestle with it. It's a lot more work. So it's important to remember that. So what do? Well, every falconer is different. There's a lot of solutions to this problem. With my hawks, I'm usually hunting rabbits. I'm here in the West in Utah, so we're hunting giant jackrabbits. So if my hawk flies ahead of me and lands on a tree or lands on a small cliff or a boulder, I'm like, good for you, bird. Now I've just become the hunting dog. And I just walk towards it, hopefully flushing rabbits, but not calling the bird. And then I will, if I don't flush any rabbits and the hawk doesn't go for anything, then I walk right past that tree or that boulder and I keep flushing. And if I walk far enough away, the hawk goes, oh no. And it goes off and it lands ahead of me again. And then I keep walking to him and pass, and then he flies past again. And so you become the hunting dog, and you are flushing for your bird. And then that is one good way to help your bird stay trained rather than the bird training you. So that's hawks. Falcons are a bit different. Most large falconers are trying to train them to wait on, which is to get them to circle up above you and to circle overhead a few hundred feet to a few thousand feet, and then you throw up a pigeon, you flush a duck, a pheasant, and your falcon dives down, knocks them out of the sky, carries them to the ground, and you go pick them up. Well, that's a very abstract concept, especially compared to what you're doing with a hawk. So while you're training a bird to do that, especially the beginning, they might be trying to figure out, what on earth, what is this human trying to get me to do? You go out, and you let your bird take off, and they go and just land. One of the reasons why we fly falcons in such open country is in part to discourage them from landing. So what's the closest object? Typically your vehicle. Your bird might go land on a car, and your instinct might be, oh, they landed. I better call them to come back to me. Don't do that. Typically, that is a bad idea, and it quickly teaches them, all just like a hawk, all they have to do is land and you will come call them for food. So instead, there's a couple of options. I just sit in the field and start walking away from them, similar to the hawk, and they're like, oh wait, where did they go? Oh, why are they leaving me? And they'll follow you. And if this is an early training session, once they are on the wing of their own choice, then you can bring out your lure and call them back. So they know, hey, it's only when I'm on the wing already that I get called back for a reward, not I go land. Now, sometimes just to get their attention, I'll walk away and I'll start throwing my glove in the air or shake my glove around a couple of times just to give them a visual cue. Oh, something's happening over there. The falconer's having fun. He's got food. I might journey over there. But you got to be careful not to do that in a way that it looks like you are calling them to a lure. Now, in a worst case scenario, just go pick up your bird without a reward. If your bird lands on a vehicle, just hop up, grab him, and then walk back out into the field, try it again. But the main thing is, with both hawks and falcons, there's a lot of different ways to address this problem, but all of the ways that you can come up with, find a way to not reward them for landing. And in the case of a hawk, you want to teach them, hey, you were on my fist, you stayed there, and you only left when you were going after quarry, and when you got that quarry, I got fed up to a huge amount that was worth the reward of waiting instead of just going and landing. And with a falcon, just teach them, hey, if you go land on a car, you don't get a reward. Instead, it's while you were circling above and you committed to a harder task that you got a far larger reward. So again, with falconry, there's a million falconers, there's a million falconry ideas out there, and there's always new ways to address these problems. I just wanted to share a couple of these problems and a couple of the solutions that seem to work well. So, as always, check out the rest of my videos on YouTube, and happy hawking.